We're batting 500. Stick around. We'll tell you how two Northwesterners became millionaire inventors.
Still ahead, they're average Northwest guys who cashed in big with their inventions.
What was really fun was to write checks out, pay all the bills with the squiggle pen.
Later, they'll reveal how they came up with their million-dollar ideas. Coming up, from meager means to millionaires. But it wasn't all that easy.
I've been through all the mistakes and all the ups and downs a person can go through.
Next, learn how a squiggle pen and a scooter with pumping power put these Northwest men on Easy Street.
You know, everyone dreams of coming up with that one big idea that will make them rich.
Some of the inventions that have come out of the Northwest, in case you didn't know, include the hacky sack, the electric guitar, and those little square plastic things that you close your bread bags with, you know, to keep the bread fresh.
Yeah.
They're called Quick Locks.
Well, now it's time to add the names of two Oregon men to the list of great Northwest inventors. Here's a look at their one simple idea and how it made them a lot of money.
I went to my patent attorney, and he said that it was the neatest thing he had seen come through his door in 40 years of patenting.
It took off right the moment they introduced it. This was a hit. This is a hit. This is going to go somewhere.
Two average Northwest guys have come up with million-dollar ideas, ideas that made them rich beyond their wildest dreams.
What was really fun was to write checks out, pay all the bills with the squiggle pen.
Rick Kristen of Sandy, Oregon, cashed in on his squiggle pen idea within a matter of months. But Mike Jones of Portland went through thousands of dollars and years of frustration before his power pumper idea saw a cent of profit.
I've been through all the mistakes and all the ups and downs a person can go through.
In 1989, Rick Kristen was working as a Portland firefighter. On the side, he toyed with inventions such as a spring-loaded Christmas tree stand.
At that point, I thought, This is quite tedious to draw all these springs. What if I had something that would actually help me draw? And then the thought hit me just like that. I need a pen that can draw springs.
So he attached a motor and a cheap Bic pen to a mini flashlight. He taped it all up, and an hour later, the Squiggle Wiggle Writer was born.
And when you turn it on, voila, there's a squiggle pen.
Rick sold his idea to a toy company immediately. And before long, he realized his life would never be the same.
Probably when I started getting the checks.
So if you take big, long strokes, you'll go fairly fast. Now I'll write it for you.
Mike Jones wasn't so fortunate.
I figured before I got a dollar back, I'd put $75,000 into this project.
Along with thousands of dollars spent on patent attorneys and parts, it took 6 years and 13 prototypes before the first power pumper ever rolled off the line.
I made every mistake possible with an idea.
6 years ago, Mike Jones was pouring cement driveways in fancy Portland neighborhoods. But one day, while shopping for a toy scooter, Mike envisioned his million-dollar idea.
And I thought, you know, if you could stand on that and push the handlebars back and forth to make it go, that would be a neat toy.
Armed with this homemade videotape, Mike peddled his idea to a bicycle company.
Three engineers looked it over, and the president says, Mr. Jones, we would like to buy your idea. And they offered me a phenomenal sum for the idea, and so I thought, wow.
But 3 months later, the bike company went flat broke, leaving Mike and his money-making idea out in the cold. Discouraged, Mike gave it all up, but eventually the power pumper caught the attention of Hart Enterprises, a young Northwest toy company. Over 2,000 power pumpers were sold in the first 6 months. And now, Portland schools are using donated power pumpers in their phys ed program. As for Rick's squiggle pen, he sold 10 million of them. As a result of their good fortune, both men have quit their day jobs to become full-time inventors and millionaires.
I can get up when I want and get to sleep when I want. If I want to stay up all night long, I can stay up all night long because I don't have to do anything the next day. And I set my own schedule. I don't let anyone set my schedule. I feel that's one of the privileges that I've earned.
Now their time is devoted to family and coming up with new inventions. However, neither man is letting his riches get out of hand. Rick still lives in the same house.
Here.
And although Mike just bought a bigger house, he stayed in the same neighborhood.
Just about what you see is what you will see from the Joneses.
So Mike Jones and Rick Kristen are still two average Northwest guys. They just happen to be rich average Northwest guys. Two inventors making the most of their million-dollar dreams.
Now, the power pumper is not in stores yet. You can order it directly from the company. As for the squiggle pen, you can find that in many toy stores and toy departments.
Great ideas. Why didn't I think of them? If you want any more information about these products, you can call our Good Evening Hotline. The number is 226-5031.
I give up.